Chairman, and thank you, Mr. Secretary, for this appearance today. Mr. Secretary, let's talk for just a moment about Dodd-Frank. I believe it to be an exceedingly important piece of legislation. Would you kindly give some indications as to how well it's performing and some indication as to how Dodd-Frank could have made a difference when we went through the 2008 crisis? As you know, AIG was styled an insurance company. Could you please elaborate to some degree?
Congressman, I think that we have made an enormous amount of progress making our financial system and the global financial system safer, and therefore the economy safer. We have taken action that raises the capital held by banks so that they are able to absorb, and financial institutions that are significant, so that they are able to absorb the risk that they are taking on. We have put in place consumer protections that didn't exist before to prevent the kind of practices that kind of metastasized in the pre-financial crisis days through the subprime lending problem. I think that if you look at the kind of back end, when institutions hit a difficult time, we've put in place resolution practices through both procedures like orderly liquidation authority and resources like the Orderly Liquidation Fund to make sure that insurers like the FDIC can manage without having to turn to taxpayers for the kind of support that was required in 2008-09. I think internationally, we have worked to try and bring global standards up to where U.S. standards now are. I know that this committee asks a lot of questions about the FSB, but what the FSB fundamentally is, it's a way for us to drive the conversation internationally so that it won't just be the United States that has high standards, but there will be high global standards, which is so important. I think we still have a lot more work to do. I think that the idea that you ever finish is probably not attainable because the financial system doesn't stop moving. It doesn't stop evolving. The next problem won't be exactly what it was in 07, 08. It's why we ask questions about things like money market funds and asset managers and other things, not because we assume that there's a problem, but because we know that if there is something that presents a kind of risk that should get our attention, we need to ask the questions in advance. The fact that there is an FSOC, the fact that there is a council that brings together all of the relevant regulators and authorities to ask the question, what do we need to be thinking about to make sure that we protect financial stability? It didn't exist before. We now have that. We put out an annual report that lists in detail what we think the concerns are, and I think that the system is enormously more safe than it was before.
The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, one piece of the puzzle. Would you just give some indication as to how important it is?
Well, Congressman, I think if you look at the work they've done, you look at the clarity with which mortgage documents are now prepared so that an individual middle-class person, a working person who's taking out a mortgage can actually understand the transaction they're entering into. Enormously important. The fact that you can't do things like low-doc, no-doc, you know, loans, fees that are hidden, costs that explode in a way that you didn't understand when you were signing on to a loan product. I think that they have done enormously powerful work in that and many other areas. And I think, notwithstanding the critique in some of the halls here, if you go into the communities, both of consumers and institutions that they deal with, there's a lot of respect for the quality of work that they've done.
How important are living wills for SIFIs?
Living wills are very important. Living wills for the largest institutions actually give you the ability to know if they were to hit the crisis point, do they have the ability to work out their problems on their own? It's why the review of living wills is such a serious piece of business. And it's hard. These are complicated organizations, and the fact that it's taking some time to get them hammered out, it shouldn't be particularly surprising. Having them in place will make the system incredibly more safe.
And you've indicated that all legislation, and you've not said this directly, but legislation can be improved upon. Are you amenable to working with Congress to make improvements?
Congressman, I've always been open to working with Congress to make the kinds of legislative changes that would improve financial oversight, improve the soundness of our system. What I haven't been open to is questions about whether the basic approach should be reevaluated or reversed.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
The gentleman has expired.